Hello, folks. Les Butler here. Facebook Live with Les, Southern Gospel Music, Memorabilia, Memories, Ministry, here tonight. And I trust all is well. And I think I have forgotten something. No, there you go. Where am I? There's this. Oh, me. Are we doing all right tonight? I'm doing fine. Million miles an hour, like always. We'll wait for a few folks to get on. If you could see this, what I've got to the right of me here, you would have me, you'd call for the authorities to come and to pack me away. It is such a mess. But it's a mess because I'm working on things and working on improving things and doing things, and that's why it's a mess. So, let's see what we got going on. Well, my Aunt Sue was first tonight. So, there you go, Sue. You're back where you're supposed to be. Numero uno. Paul Hyde, what's up, cousin? Hey, Paul, I sent you an email a while ago. There's a syndicated radio show on in like 100 markets that featured you this week. And I sent that email to you. So, thought that was a cool thing. Let's see who else we have. We got Glendon. Hello, Vic Zabelka, Chicago, Vic Zabelka. Bears are playing tonight, Vic. Patty and Glendon. And Paul, I haven't seen your office. That's right. It could be worse. I don't know. If it is, God bless you. You need to be taken by the authorities and put away. Maybe we'll get adjoining cells and do some duo gospel music in jail. Hello, Heather. Hello, Patty. Hello, Paul. Yep. All right. So I've got this. Tonight's show is going to be a hodgepodge of stuff. It's going to be a hodgepodge. Is hodgepodge a word? If it isn't, I just made it one. Hodgepodge. Going to play some music you've probably never heard before in your life. And it's not real old. It's 16 years old. Not, you know, I always bring out vinyl from 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years ago. So it's not that kind of old. Plus, I've got all kinds of memorabilia tonight, anyway, okay, so let's do my thing here. All right, we got Christmas. Always got to do my stuff. Hello, David Brown. I've got some calls coming your way, David, for liners and whatnot. I hope it works for you. And tell people about David. Put your radio in there. Hey, there's Jerry and Alita. How you doing? Oh, that's another Jerry and Alita that I know. It's a different Jerry and Alita. Well, nonetheless, Jerry and Alita, how you doing? Melton Campbell. Melton, I sing with the inspiration sometimes. Campbell, good to see you. So here you go. December 7, 8, and 9. What you need to do is you need to get your adult Sunday school class to go and be a part of this, because we're going to do a lot of eating. We're going to do some singing too. Then when we're done singing, we're going to eat. When we're going to preach some, then we're going to eat. Are you picking up on a theme? So there you go. It's going to be myself, Old Time Preachers Quartet, and the Rollins, and Bob Sellers, and Sacred Harmony, and Sherry Taylor, and Chelsea Estes, and Covenant, Paul Boland, December 7, 8, 9. And here's the number for you. Call 865-278-3681, 865-278-3681. Don't forget, get you a mug, Facebook Live with Les mug. Check him out, the old chubby face. There you go. Thank you, David. MyHarborRadio.com. Check him out, my friend David. Eat, 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 sleep, repeat. David, you picked up on what I was laying down. So there you go. There I am, chubby cheeks, my headphones, my glasses, and all the radio gear and whatnot. And Facebook Live with Les, Southern Gospel Music, Memorabilia, Memories Ministry. So go get you one. Would you do that? I'd appreciate it very much. And I'll put some stuff in it too, some free stuff on top of getting the mug. Do that. You can go to butlermusicgroup.com and go to the store there and check it out. You can also go there to the store and buy my new album. I Like Southern Gospel Style the Best is the name of it. The new single to radio is That's My Preacher, in support of this month being Pastor Appreciation Month. And you can go to, let's see what it is. Let me try to find it here. So I can tell you the real facts instead of just, here we go. You can go to familymusicgroup.com/contest. Familymusicgroup.com/contest. And you can put your pastor in, submit your pastor in to be eligible to win a gift bag valued at $500 full of CDs and DVDs and shirts and books and hats and all kinds of stuff. And a pair of tickets to the Mike Huckabee TV show, and a pair of tickets, and a meet and greet with him, by the way, and a pair of tickets to the Passion Play just south of Branson, Missouri. And guess what? The person that submits that pastor, we're going to randomly choose the pastor, the winning pastor, but whoever chose or submitted that pastor for the contest, they're going to win the same prize package. So you need to go to familymusicgroup.com/contest and put your pastor there. And you can listen to a little clip of my song. If you want to download the song, you can download it. If you want to pre-order the CD, and I'll give you a bunch of free stuff for doing it, you can get all of that right there at familymusicgroup.com/contest. Okay? Okay. So Tuesday night, we had Don Reed, the second part of a 7-part video series that I did with Don Reed, interview I did with him, of the Statler Brothers. And so you can go back and watch the first and the second video on my Facebook page and mark down your calendar for October 12th. That's, I think that's next Monday. That's going to be the third of the 7-part series there with Don Reed of the Statler Brothers. So we would love for you to watch all of these. They've been great. Thousands have viewed them so far. You need to do it. And then whenever you watch the video interview, then the very next thing that happens, like a minute later, you have to scroll on my page there. There I am doing a Facebook Live featuring the great gospel quartet music of the Statler Brothers, playing their music and having a big time there. And so do that. And also, if you like Southern Gospel Quartet music, please go to Dollywood on October 28th because the Old Time Preachers Quartet will be there singing, and I'd love for you to be there with us, okay? So that's October 28th. It's just coming right around the corner. We'll be on the park at Dollywood all day long singing 4 or 5 different shows. So, and we will make them different, by the way. So come to all of them, all right? And a church is apt to break out at Dollywood, just so you know, because I've worked Dollywood for like 20 years now. And I'm telling you, man, we have had full-blown, full-on Holy Ghost church and camp meeting at Dollywood. A couple years ago at one of the Heaven's Mountain Band concerts, we got to lead a young man to the Lord. There's been preachers pop up and preach. There's been shouting. Old-fashioned revival at Dollywood. And I'm expecting it on the 28th. I want the Lord to show up in a big way, and I want you to show up and be a part of it. So be there, okay? All right, so so that's it for all of the stuff. Hey, Mike Keller, praying for you, brother. I told you the last few days, that I did a trip to Shipshewana, the Blue Gate Theater there in Shipshewana, Indiana. This has been, I don't know how many years ago, 10 years. Is there a date on this thing? No, there's no date. About 10 years ago. And it was a big old thing. I mean, all kinds of quartets and groups and Collingsworth family and Triumphant and Tribute. And just, I mean, there was a bunch of people. And I was a part of that for the Singing News. I was the publisher at that point. So I sat up a table and did some things. And anyway, we were there the day early and we played football. And Dennis Duggar of Tribute reminded me, because he was on with me the other day, that I threw him the winning touchdown pass in our game that we played with a bunch of the guys from Tribute and Triumphant. And like I say, Collingsworth boys were there. We just had a big old football game out in this big old field. Then we had the big concert for a couple nights in a row. Well, anyway, in the bus, they let me have the back bedroom, and we were driving from Nashville to Shipshewana, Indiana. In the middle of the night, I had to get up and do something, or I wanted a drink or something. I forgot what it was. But anyway, so I get up, and so I'm not familiar with the bus and the stuff. And so I get up, and there's a row of cabinets above the bed, above my head. And I get up, and I mean, I crack my head into bleeding all over the place. And I'm thinking, okay, I'm going to die in Shipshewana, Indiana. But obviously I made it through. But anyway, so a few days after that, the Tribute Quartet fellows came into my office at Singing News, and they brought me a little something. They brought me a helmet and put my name on the back of the helmet. And and so there you go. There is some Southern Gospel memorabilia for you. They all signed it and all that kind of stuff. And it was fun. It was funny. And so since I told that story the other day, I stumbled upon the helmet because I'm cleaning out some things and doing some things and getting ready to put our museum together and whatnot. And anyway, so I stumbled upon that. And so there you are. There's the helmet I was talking about. And by the way, what's even funnier is, and this, I didn't have the helmet on that night, obviously, because I cracked my head open, but they got a helmet that was cracked. So somebody's used this helmet, and they cracked their head, and probably, unlike me, didn't bleed to death because they had the helmet on. Okay, so there you are. There's that. Okay, now, here's some more. I've got a lot of memorabilia tonight. Now I'm going to tie this into some music because you all want to hear music. You don't want to hear me just yak all night long. So, Thursday, February 26th, 2004. Guess where your old buddy Les was? Take a guess. Hello, Jerry Miner. Good Thursday evening, Brother Les. Yes, sir. Good to see you. And there's Derek, and there's Vicky. Old Mike popped his head. Mike, you can borrow my helmet the next time. So on February 26, 2004, here's the ticket. I went to see President George W. Bush speak in Louisville, Kentucky. There's the ticket. And I got to go because of a group that was on my family music group label at the time named Soul Real, S-O-U-L-R-E-A-L. Three ladies from Louisville, Kentucky, and man, could they sing. And we're going to play a couple of their songs here in just a minute. But because of their generosity and kindness, I got to go in and see George W. Bush speak. I didn't get my picture with him, but I was on the second row, and when he went down the receiving line, which was the front row, the first row, I got some pictures of him going down that row because he went right by me, and I got to say something to him, and he responded to me. I'll tell you about that in a minute. But first, let's do this, and then I'm going to show you some of the pictures I took there in the receiving line, and I got more stories. I got a story about parking at the hotel the night before and then that hotel that morning. It's just, if you've never gone to see a president, the stuff you got to go through is absolutely unreal. And the entire experience is simply unbelievable. And so anyway, but let's listen to some music from the group I'm talking about, Soul Real. These girls could sing, is what I'm saying. So let's listen to a song here called I Think About You. Soul Real, going back to about 2004, 16 years ago. These gals are from Louisville, Kentucky, and can sing. You're going to enjoy it. Facebook Live with Les right here. Sing together as a group. When they did, they were great, and they were on my label back in 2004. Margaret, Rhonda, Joe, and Leslie, and I hope they're doing well these days, and I hope somebody gets says, you ought to go see Facebook Live with Les, man. He was talking about y'all and playing some of your music, and I'm going to play another song here in a minute. But, okay, so I showed you my ticket there to see President George W. Bush right there. I'll show you again. It's for real. Now, in addition to that, I took some pictures. I was on the second row. The receiving line was in the front. And so I've got pictures as he was going down the receiving line. And I'll show you the pictures that I took. Right there's one of them. And right there he is. At Secret Service there, closer to the camera, and then Secret Service past the camera. And here he was on the stage, getting ready to speak after he was introduced. President Bush. And then here he is as he is speaking. And again, I was in the second row and got some great pictures there. Now, if you've never seen a president, so I go the night before to Louisville. I drive from Nashville to Louisville, Kentucky. And I stay at the Galt House. Anybody ever stay at the Galt House in Louisville? Raise your hand if you did. Yes, I see those hands. You park in an underneath parking lot. Parking lot is under the Galt House, because I've been there many times back when the National Quartet Convention was in Louisville, and many times when the IBMA was there, and me and my family would stay there. So I know right where to go, and so I go, and you can't get in the parking lot. And so I park off on the side and just look underneath where the parking lot is, and there isn't a single car in the place. I'm thinking, did I mess something up? Am I in the wrong? Have they closed the hotel? What's going on? And so I have to park like a half a mile down the road in downtown Louisville with all of my clothes and stuff. And so I go park. And I go, I'm finally making it to the hotel. And sure enough, the hotel's open and it's bustling and everything's going on. And I said, so what's the deal? Why hasn't anybody parking underneath the parking lot? And they said, George Bush is going to be speaking here at a luncheon tomorrow, and they won't allow any cars to park there because the cars could have dynamite and this, that, and the other, and blow the place up, and they won't allow it. I thought, okay, I'll buy that. And so he was there. Now, I didn't see him at the hotel speak. He was speaking at an industrial building about industrial business and things like that later in the afternoon, which is what my ticket was for. Location was ISCO Industries on Chestnut Street in Louisville. So anyway, so he's in my hotel like 11:30 the next morning. And so I get out of bed, and I got to check out and all that kind of stuff. And so I go over to the elevator and I hit the button. The elevator opens. And there is a Secret Service man, my size, 6'4", good-sized man, and two dogs that could have won the Kentucky Derby. They were as big as horses. Biggest dogs I've ever seen in my life. One to the left, one to the right, and right there is the Secret Service guy. And so they open, and I said, y'all have a good day. I'll wait for the next one. I didn't move a muscle, thinking that I might get eaten by two horse dogs or shot by a Secret Service man. So it closes. I go and I leave, and everything's fine. And it's just an unusual experience. And so then I go to the industrial place, and you park and you get out, and there's a bunch of people, and then you have to go through. You have to have, I forgot what all I had to have. I had to have my driver's license, like a social security card and some other kind of document. And then they make you empty all of your pockets, take your coat off, and they do a full body scan. And then you have to walk through this scanner thing and then another full body scan, and your stuff gets scanned, and just wow. So then you make it in, and then you sit down, and you know, and everything's, you're just excited, and man, the president's going to speak a little bit. And so it's supposed to be 2:00. 2:00, no president. 2:05, no president. 2:15, no president. 2:30, no president. 2:45, no president. Then about 3:05 or so, you start hearing what ends up being a rumble. Wasn't a rumble at the time, but there was a noise in the distance. And about every 15 seconds, it started to get somewhat louder and then somewhat louder. And then about after 2 minutes of it getting somewhat louder, then all of a sudden, about 2 minutes or so into, you start hearing a loud rumble. And then about another minute or two into it, it's so loud you can't hear yourself think. And the building starts reverberating and shaking. So everybody's kind of like stunned, and I'm one of them. And then it calms down, and then you start seeing men in black suits, as you see like in movies, start coming in and milling around and whatnot. And so it's Secret Service. And then a minute or two later, they usher in George W. Bush. So that was the whole entourage that's with a president and this kind of a thing. And they had, I mean, I don't know, he must have been ushered in with Sherman tanks or something. I didn't see what all and who all was out there. But I'm talking about loud folks and shaking a huge industrial building. So, wow. And so just before he comes in, the group that was on my label, Soul Real, these gals right here, they sang. They sang, they sang a song, and then they sang, I think, a song or two, and then the national anthem. I mean, they had a little concert going on with these people and President Bush. It was just cool. It was all get out. And so I'll play another song for you by Soul Real. I just want to thank them for a memory that will last a lifetime. Getting to listen to George Bush speak, going through the whole experience of everything, parking, and you can't park under the hotel anymore, and then two dogs that look like horses, and the scanning, and the just everything was just unbelievable. Okay, let me play a song, and then I'll tell you what I told President Bush, and I'll give you his response. But let me just play one more song here by Soul Real, and then after that, I've got another piece of memorabilia I'm going to show you, and a song that I'm going to do. But here's one of my all-time favorite hymns, and these girls just knock it out of the park. Here's Soul Real with I'd Rather Have Jesus.
I'd rather have Jesus.
Amen.
I'd rather be true to his heart.
that wasn't going to be my my ministry moment I was going to do tonight, but I'm just going to mind the Lord. I'm just going to jump in right there. I would rather have Jesus, certainly, than men's applause. I've had men's applause. I've sung and played in front of 20,000 people multiple times in my life. And the applause was wonderful for that moment. And you get off of the stage and it's gone. You know, it's just the way it is. I'm going to shoot straight with you on something. You know, I was the publisher of the Singing News for, I don't know, several years. And I ran the Singing News Radio Network, then known as the Solid Gospel Radio Network, for 20 years. And when I was in those positions, everybody in the gospel music world, from people you've never heard of before to the highest ranking people that everybody in this world knows, had my cell phone number, had my email address, and I heard from them all the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365. And when I left all of that to do my own thing and to be part of the Old Time Preachers Quartet and to preach and to sing and have my own company and do gospel music the way I want to do it and the way I think the Lord would have me to do it, it's amazing how all of those people, hundreds, that had my phone number and had my email address, how they all at one time in one day lost it. They lost my phone number. They lost my email address. Never, ever, ever hear from them. Ever. And I'm talking about people that I've done my very best to help in all of the highest levels of what I did on the radio and in the magazine and all that. I hadn't heard from them for years since I walked out the door. So you can have your men and your men's applause. I'd rather have Jesus. The very reason I get to go to heaven is because of Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have the rest. I'd rather have Jesus than worldwide fame. Worldwide fame, you can have that. I've had that. Name was at the very top of the ladder in the Singing News when you opened up when I was publisher, top name. That would be me. I've hosted radio shows on Delta Airlines. I'm not bragging. I'm giving God the glory for all of it. But I'm trying to tell you something. If you'll listen to me. TV shows, hosted TV shows for years, on and on and on. Tried to honor the Lord in everything that I did with all of that. Probably failed miserably, at least in some areas. I tried. All of that didn't amount to a hill of beans, other than what good came from it in lifting up the Lord. Because if He's lifted up, all men will be drawn to Him. So hopefully that happened, that I lifted up the Lord and some people were drawn to Him. But just on a personal level, all of the people and the stuff that I work with and all that, they lost my phone number and my email address. What about that? Guess what? The Lord didn't lose my phone number. He didn't lose my email address. He knows right where I live. You want to know how I know He knows where I live? Because he meets with me here every day. Right here, my home. He talks to me every day when I open up His Word. He still talks to me. Praise His holy name. I've got awards. I've got them on shelves and all that, and they collect dust. Not that I'm not thankful for them. I'm thankful for them. God has been good to me. I didn't deserve anything that I've just talked about. Didn't deserve any of it. None of it. I deserved what you deserve, to be on a slick road to hell. But Jesus. So, I'd rather have Jesus than the accolades, than the names, than the awards. Just give me Jesus. Amen. I love that song. That song's got the touch of God on it. Yes, it does. Well, there you go. Well, I was going to do something else, but I ain't going to do it now, because I needed to do that. I hope I honored God in what I said. So I had another song, another thing I was going to do, another piece of memorabilia, but I'm not going to do that now. But let me just see what I've got here. I tell you what I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to do this. I'm just going to play one more song, and we're going to call it a day. And this wasn't supposed to be on the program and all that, but I've got a CD that was a part of just something I picked up. And sure enough, the Lord's got a song that we need to play right now on that CD. Aren't you glad when he takes care of it all? I've thrown away everything I was going to do from this point on for the program tonight. But I'll play one more song. And we'll save this other piece of memorabilia and the other song and the other stuff for another day. But before I play this other song, let me just see who's on here with us. Can I do that? Because I've been yakking here a long time. Did you like I'd Rather Have Jesus by Soul Real? Did you enjoy that? Man, what a song. I just love it. Hello, Gerald Crow. See what Mike Keller's saying. Sometime I will tell you about the first time I ever saw President Bush Sr. after he flew into Topeka, Kansas, won the first time 747 Air Force One. The first 747 Air Force One. There you go. Hello, Jackie Fortner. Hey, Ricky. I got you. Ricky Lester, if you're still there, I got your voicemail. Brother, I'm so snowed under. If you stayed with me for 24 hours, you'd walk away saying, Lord, help this man. He's lost his mind. But I'm going to be in the studio all day tomorrow tracking with my friends, the Bachelor family, looking for a great time there. It's going to be a great record. And then working on a bunch of stuff Saturday for improving my Facebook Live shows and YouTube channel that I'm working on. And then Sunday's church. Call me again Monday, Ricky, is what I'm trying to say. Okay? I'm not running from you, brother. Call me again. Call me Monday. I promise you. I want to talk to you. Well, look, there's my daughter, Amber. She's doing some work for me these days. She did a great job today on some things. I appreciate that. Greg Quick. Hey, Les. Good to see you. Mike, he was worshiping the Lord there. I'm glad you tuned in, Mike, and I hope it blessed you, man. It blessed me. I'd rather have Jesus than diamonds and silver and gold. I'd just rather have Jesus. Jeremiah, nothing like being alone with just him. Hallelujah, Jeremiah. There's Shelley. He'll never lose your number. No, I know. He calls me up every day. Jim McComas, preach. Jim, I was telling the truth there, brother. Thank you for saying that. Thank you for supporting that. No go with me. My Aunt Sue says, I'll follow you. Thank you, Aunt Sue. Chuck Robbins. No turning back. No turning back. No, no. Hello, Patty. Hallelujah. Amen. She was liking it. Thank you for understanding, Ricky. Call me Monday, brother. I promise you. We're going to hook up. It's going to happen. Hello, Jamie Simmons, Middle Tennessee Baptist Church, Jamie Simmons. Okay, so there we go. So I'm going to play, and this wasn't scheduled, and it was just here. I'm telling you, it was just here. I didn't put it there not for tonight anyway. I guess I put it there. A CD that just didn't roll over by itself. But I'm going to play, it's a song by the Dunaways. You know, there's people that you've worked with throughout life that you couldn't, you found out that you couldn't trust. And people that you can't trust. But you can sure trust the Lord. You can trust His book. You can trust what He says He will do in that book. And for nearly 59 years, I can testify to you tonight, He's never let me down. He's never failed me. I have Him. He hasn't been able to trust me all the time, but I've been able to trust Him. And here's a song by the Dunaways that'll tell you that. And my, this song is powerful. You are getting ready to be ushered into the presence of the Lord right now. I still trust you, Lord.
I've seen the righteous man suffer pain, and it looked like the wicked would go free.
Oh, yes.
And in my frustration, it just didn't seem right.
You ever been frustrated?
I ask you for sunshine, but you sent a rain.
You sent a rain, Lord.
I cried for healing, but I only got pain.
Been there.
But I know your love will see me through.
I've been there.
Oh, Lord, I still trust you.
Trust Him tonight.
Yes, I know you're able.
where to go. I'll just trust him. You know, I have found for sure, especially in the industry in which I work, trust is just something that you can't do. You don't get it. Oh, there's much I want to say, but I'm not going to say it. Just all I know is this. He's never failed me. He's never forsaken me. He's going to be with me all the way to the end of this world in my life here. And then I'm going to either close my eyes and be with him in death, or in a moment, the twinkling of an eye, I'm going to go and be with him. If I'm still on this earth and alive, when the trumpet blows, the dead in Christ is going to rise first, and we which are alive and remain, we're headed up with him to be with him forever. And that word I trust. I don't trust the word of many men. I don't trust the word of some preachers. I don't trust the word of some relatives. And God knows I don't trust the word of a lot of people in the industry in which I work. But I trust the Lord. And he's proven himself to me time and time and time and time again. I still trust you, Lord. Well, amen and amen to that. Y'all probably want to hear that again, don't you? I hope so, because I'm playing it again. If you got to go, turn it off and go. I'm just going to sit here and bask in it. I'm living that this very moment.
I ask you for sunshine, but you sent rain.
I've seen that.
I cried for healing, but I only got pain.
We've all experienced that.
I know your love will see me through.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, I still trust you.
I'm just going to trust him. When it looks dark and dreary, I'm just going to trust him. When the sun's shining, I'm just going to trust him. When the bank account is full, I'm going to trust him. When there's nothing in the bank account, I'm going to trust him. When the cars start, I'm going to trust him. When they don't start, I'm going to trust him. When the world embraces me and accepts me, I'll trust him. When they throw me out to the curb, I'm going to trust him. Oh, yeah, I'm going to trust you, Lord.
So let me hold to your hand.
We're quick to hold to the hand of the world and those around us. We need to run to him.
I trust you, for you've been
proven that. Yeah, he will.
Your blood, it has cleansed me from all my guilt.
And nothing but the blood.
Your cross, I know I can hold on to.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, I trust you.
If you know the chorus by now, just rear back and sing it as unto the Lord. Yes, hallelujah.
Lord, I know you're able to guide me through this soldier I'm around.
You ever been there? You don't know where to go or who to turn to.
Which way to turn?
You don't know whether to go or stop or go backward or go forward. Sometimes we just need to stand and wait upon the Lord. Stand still. And while you're standing there, just hold to his hand. I thank the Dunaways for such a great song right there. I still trust you. Still my favorite song from them. My, what a song. Well, hallelujah. We just need to trust on. Hey, Brother John, I hope you're doing well. Brother John Hillenthal, good to see you, sir. Mike Keller, but I'll trust him through all this. Yes, sir. Patty, the God who doesn't change can change everything. We just have to trust him. Hallelujah. I answer yes so many times. I just reach out my hand out to God to hold on to. He's always there, never leaves us, never forsakes us. Well, hallelujah. Terry Baker, good to see you, sir. Brother Jeremiah, whoo, glad I jumped on, needed this glory. Well, I'm glad you did too, Brother Jeremiah. Jeremiah, hallelujah. Let the Holy Spirit lead, brother, I did. Well, there's my father-in-law, old D. Kent Nelkin, saying, yes, glory to his name. Amen. He's been better to me than I deserve, praise his name. You're right, Kenny, he has. And I'm in the boat rowing with you there, brother. Joshua Phillips, good to see you. Hell, he's got some praise hands up. Well, glory. Just go ahead and worship. Mike Keller says, I'm celebrating my birthday at home with Linda. Both of us with COVID-19 will praise the Lord anyway. That's all you can do, Brother Mike. Oh, that's all you can do. Just praise him. He's there with you. It could be so much worse. What if you weren't saved? There you are sitting there on your birthday, COVID, and didn't have the Lord with you. Oh my, it would be much worse. There are days I like to be all alone with Christ my Lord. Oh boy. Yes. Yes, sir, Ken. Well, oh yeah, Hold to God's Unchanging Hands, one of my all-time favorite Red Book songs. Sister Tennille at church last night sang, I think it was last night she sang it. Man, I love it. I love to hear her sing it. Amen. Well, I hope somebody's been helped tonight. And it took a turn that I wasn't looking for, but that's okay. God turned it, and so I wasn't about to mess with it. When he turned something, hands off the wheel for me. Turn it, Lord. And the other piece that I had, we'll do that on another night, and it'll be fine, and everything will be well. Amen. If we have Jesus, we have all we need. That's exactly right, brother. That's right, Ed Drury. Amen and amen. Well, if y'all got blessed by this, you need to hit the share button because somebody else may need this blessing. So do that. And then if all goes well, Lord willing, tomorrow night, I'm in the studio, but I might be able to get back home in time tomorrow night to do a Facebook Live at some time. So be keeping an eye peeled there, and we'll do another Facebook Live, if not sometime Saturday, as I'm working on this the stuff that I'm doing for Facebook Live and a YouTube channel, and going to be a work day, but we'll stop long enough to work some more and do a show. Okay? All right. Well, God bless you all. That's it. Have a good night.